He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Hey guys, for today's practice problem, we're going to want to look at this reaction here. This is a hydrogenation over platinum metal. And what we're going to want to do is be able to draw both products that will result from this, state their relationship, that's going to be their stereochemical relationship, and then we're going to want to be able to state which one is more thermodynamically favorable of the two. So if any of this looks confusing to you, you're going to want to go back and check out my lectures on addition reactions, specifically hydrogenation, as well as aspects of stereochemistry. And as a hint, to do number three, you're going to need to be able to draw cyclohexane chair conformations, so you're going to want to watch that tutorial as well. So give it a shot. Okay guys, let's take a look at the answer. Now the first thing we want to understand is the stereospecificity of hydrogenation over platinum metal. So remember that this is heterogeneous catalysis. So the way that this works is that we have a solid surface of platinum and the hydrogen atoms are sticking out like this. So when the molecule lowers down, it is necessarily the case that the hydrogen atoms are added in syn fashion from the same side of the molecule. Okay, so that means that we have two options because this portion of the molecule is planar. They can either add like that or from behind the board, like that. So let's say that they add from behind the board. We've got the two hydrogens coming in. They're going to be on the other side. That means this methyl is going to get pushed out. Now, the two hydrogen atoms that we added, those are implied, so we haven't drawn them in, but if we were to, those would be on the dash bonds right here, hydrogen, hydrogen, and that's why the methyl got pushed out. Now, the other option is if they were added from this side of the molecule, like that. That means the implied hydrogens would both be wedges right there, and that means that the existing methyl had to get pushed back. So here are the two resulting compounds, and so we have a cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, and we have a trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Now these are chiral, or actually this one is not chiral, and this one is chiral, but we have to understand that those are diastereomers. Those are diastereomers because this stereocenter has the same configuration, but this stereocenter has opposite configuration. And so anytime molecules differ in one or more but not all of the stereocenters, those are going to be diastereomers. So that is the stereochemical relationship between them. Now, if we want to talk about the thermodynamic favorability, we're going to have to draw the chair conformations. So I've drawn the two chair conformations for each molecule. This is the cis. Now, remember for cis, what we're saying here is if these are both up, they're both on the same side of the ring, both of the methyl groups are up, that means that whichever chairs you've chosen to draw, the methyl groups have to be on the same side of the ring. So I've arbitrarily chosen these two carbons here. So let's say that that I'm calling this carbon 1 and I'm calling that carbon 1, and then I'm going around like this, 2, 3. Well, then that would be 2, 3 right here, right? And now, when this chair flips, this is going to be the resulting chair, because remember, the leftmost carbon remains the leftmost carbon, then you continue to number in the same way that you did. So there's our 1,3, there's our 1,3. And now, the thing is here, this one is diaxial, which makes this one diequatorial. Now, and that is the case because any substituent that is axial on one chair will become equatorial on the other chair and vice versa. So we have our diaxial conformation, we have our diequatorial conformation. That is for the cis molecule. Now for the trans molecule, we've got one axial, one equatorial. That means when we flip it, we're going to get that one equatorial and that one axial. Now, we know that the axial position is going to be less thermodynamically favorable because of the diaxial interactions that are happening. So the equatorial position is the more favorable one of the two. That means that this is the most favorable conformation because both of the methyl groups are in the equatorial position, and that means that the cis compound is the more thermodynamically favorable of the two in terms of conformation. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.